Okay, I just wait, I need to look at this first. Sorry, these slides are actually okay, these slides were actually meant for a presentation I gave. You can see 14 September 2018. So I shall reuse the slides given the impromptu nature of this. Okay, so just intro, what's my background first lah. Okay, so I graduated from NUS Computer Science 2015. Now I work at SP Digital right here. Okay, so I'm Michael's colleague also. Yeah, so I've given quite a bit of talks. So you can see this is the number of talks I've given. Yeah, and I've spoken at three conferences, two times at iOS Conf and one time at CofferCon. Okay. So maybe a bit of history, how I got started. Basically, I got arrowed by my professor to give a talk. So like that, yeah. So I thought, why not? Just go for it, right? Yeah, so I just give the talk. Then actually that kick-started my journey into public speaking and meetups and conferences lah. Okay, so I gave my first talk at this Hackers and Painters is a meetup. This meetup is no longer existing already. So it's my first time speaking there. Really scary. I think I don't know how many of you have spoken at a meetup before, but your first time is always the most nerve-wracking. Yeah, but I got through it and I started to I forgot all my slides already. Okay. Oh yeah, how do you come up with talks? Okay, so erase the junior test part. Okay, so what can you talk about as a, if you want to speak at a conference or meetup, personal projects, if you cannot think of a personal projects, then think of a basic introductory talks. Another thing that I find interesting is if you have a niche interest, right, that could really appeal to a meetup or conference because maybe it's an interesting talk, but no one has given a talk about it before. So immediately that makes you stand out. So for me, my personal interest is in retro computing. If y'all don't know, retro computing is like to make old stuff run in modern times. Like make old computers or old hardware and software run in modern times. That is a very niche thing. Yeah, so, and I submitted these talks to the hackware award, then people are very happy about it. Yeah, so maybe you can try that in the conference. Yeah. Okay, so these are the three goals, what I normally do. So if anything you want to take away from my talk is these three things. Open source, blog post, and the talk. So a talk need not always need to come first, right? You can start with the project first, you open source it, then make it open. After that, you write a blog post about it. Then your blog post can serve as a script for a talk. So when you apply for a conference or a meetup talk, right, you can actually use your blog post and your GitHub link as supporting evidence for your talk. Rather than just submitting your talk abstract, right, it's a bit like there is no skeletons or meat behind it. But if, let's say, the conference organizers see that, oh, you actually have a blog post about it, right? You know what you're going to say. They know what you're going to do. So it's immediately clear to them that, okay, at least maybe you really have something to talk about, rather than just words on the in your abstract. Lah. Okay, I shall skip this. Oh, some tips. You can pair with the senior speaker. So this is my first time I gave a talk at a conference, iOS Conf, about 2 years ago. So I was a bit scared, so the organizer, Soup, right, of iOS Conf, he said, why not just pair with me? Yeah, so that at least there's someone helping me as well. It won't be a totally scary thing. Set a deadline for yourself. So a conference is a good way to make you get started, make you do stuff. Okay, so this is when I submitted my talk at the GopherCon. Yeah, they say accepted. So it was actually quite a scary thing. I submitted really just for fun. Just now, what's his name?
Thomas.
Thomas, right? You say he have a lot, all the funny abstract, right? So I actually just did a similar thing. Okay, well, most of us do this. I'll tend to do something like that. I just actually did it just for fun. I didn't really expect it. Okay, congratulations, your talk has been accepted. Oh my god. What did I just get myself into? Yeah, but never mind, just submit for fun. Who knows, you might get accepted and you just do the talk. Benefits. Yeah, increase your network, improve your presentation skills. Free conference entry or a free trip to another country. Yeah, why not? Yeah, I'm a conference cheapskate. So I like to go to conferences for free. So I either volunteer for them, run record for Michael, or just be the speaker. Yeah. A bonus benefit. What is the bonus? Oh yeah, your future boss might be in the audience. Who knows, right? This is a true story. Actually, my department head, SP Digital, he attended my talk. Then after my talk, he offered me a job. Who knows, right? You attend a conference, right? Maybe the department head of some big company, big tech company is there. Then you're like, oh, you speak very well. Okay, I should offer you a job. Who knows, right?
Don't say
this one. Oh, yeah. Okay. Reserve. Okay, I think that's all right.
Yeah. I hope he will still be my friend after this, because I clearly sabo him. I owe you like dinner, whatever okay. You want. Yeah, have you carry heavy objects?